Welcome to this X8R video. A common fault on the Z3, you can see here the seat bushes have worn down, leading to excess movement in the seat. Start by removing the seat belt from the base of the seat. Remove the 16mm bolt. Once the bolt is loosened and finger tight, you'll be able to remove the seat belt from the base. Removing the seat belt from the locator, as shown. Now, move the seat into the fully forward position to allow access to the rear bolts. Remove both 16mm bolts holding the seat to the floor, one either side. With both rear bolts removed, move the seat to the fully back position, allowing access to the two 13mm nuts on the front. Remove both 13mm nuts, again, one either side. With the seat unbolted now, this will allow access to the electrical connectors underneath. Remove the electrical connectors as in the video. Also, there may be an additional plug underneath the seat. This will also need to be removed. Now, with the seat removed from the vehicle, you can see the movement in the sliders. To remove the sliders, start by removing the two T25 Torx that you can see, as shown. Now, with the two T25 Torx removed, the slider will be able to be moved much more easily than it was previously. This will allow access to the top T50 Torx. With the T50 Torx removed, this will allow you to remove the spindle from the seat runner. Grabbing the top of the spindle, you have to slide up the seat runner at the same time, allowing you to remove the spindle from the seat runner, as shown. Key point. When removing, you need to remove the threaded part from the spindle. In preparation for refitting, count how many turns you do, as you need to have it in the same position on refitting. Using a flat-bladed screwdriver, lift out the center of the bushes from the bush housing. This is the remnants of the old bushes. This needs to be cleaned out before fitting the new bushes. Now, with the old parts of the bushes removed, it's time to fit the new bushes. Slot the new bushes in and slot in the threaded part. At this stage, it will not fit. The bushes will need slight adjustment. With an 80 grit sandpaper, sand down the bushes very, very slightly all around them, sanding equally on each side on both bushes. Once you have sanded them and the threaded part slots in easily, now you can press the threaded part back into the housing. Using a vise, clamp it in and start to wind. This will only get to a certain point. You need a 5mm socket to allow it to press in the rest of the way. Using the 5mm socket, try to make sure it is aligned centrally when winding it in to allow you to thread the spindle back on. Make sure it is squarely inside, as shown. With the bushes in, it's time to reattach the spindle into the threaded part of the housing, remembering how many turns you did when removing to allow the seat to be in the correct position. Now, with everything threaded back on, it's time to realign it, making sure the gear is in the correct position, as shown. Slot in the spindle, making sure it is aligned correctly, and slide it down, sliding down the seat runner at the same time. There is a small inspection hatch, as shown in the video. You need to align the drive on the spindle into the correct position using a flat-bladed screwdriver. Now, with the seat bolted back up, refit the T50 torque, making sure it is tight. Refitting the T25 torques in the lower part of the seat runner, again, making sure they are tight. Again, repeat the same procedure for the bushes on the other side. You can see here the seat is now successfully repaired with no excess movement. Thank you for watching this X8R video. If you have any questions or inquiries, please contact us on 01843 446643, or you can email us at sales@x8r.co.uk. Thank you.